All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. This is a special emergency transmission on this May 2nd, 2009, Saturday evening, 9 p.m. to 10 p.m., only 1 hour long. This is the second emergency transmission I've done since last Saturday. We have the normally scheduled syndicated radio program, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. It's on the AM and FM dial across the nation. It can also be listened to at PrismPlanet.com and Infowars.com, or subscribe to it, the podcast there. But we have the studios here for the PrismPlanet.tv viewers and the internet listeners on the streams at Infowars.com. We appreciate all the thousands and thousands of folks that have tuned in since I posted on Infowars.com today that we would be here this evening. Okay, let me, in as focused a manner as I can, go through why we're doing another emergency broadcast here. We know the government lies and spins. We know it's corporately owned by foreign offshore banks. And they even had the Democratic leader of the Senate just came out, and it's in Salon magazine, and said basically foreign banks completely run and dominate and control this nation. And so we know that mainstream media predominantly is there to fearmonger for this establishment and sell the police state, sell the control grid so these crooks can stay in power. And until we start focusing in on the establishment and stop focusing on their left-right puppets they distract us with, things are only going to get worse. Now, we have seen the architecture for control, for domination of societies, being built around phony environmental crises, phony terrorist threats, and phony biological threats. Those are three of the mainstays. They also stage financial crises, which give them more power. Then they terrorize the public into giving them even more power and control in the name of fixing the crisis they created. And they always only make the crisis worse. And then time and time again, because people are on a one-day news cycle, they don't think back to 2 or 3 years ago how the bankers set up the crisis we're now living in. And 2 or 3 years from now, when we're worse off, people won't think back to the crisis they set up to begin with. But there's a little bit of background there. Let me go ahead and get into this emergency transmission right now with what we're facing and what we're dealing with here. Let me just read through the bullet points I've written here, then I'll go through the news that backs it all up. A huge mind control exercise, a literal war on freedom and liberty worldwide, is taking place. And you can just Google, UN says swine flu outbreak good for globalism. Or globalists say flu outbreak good for world government. And you will see them in the news bragging that this is helping them set up a world government. They need a crisis to offer their solution. This is a takeover drill, a federalization drill, not just in the U.S. or Canada or Mexico, but in Europe and all over the planet. Governments love to grandstand and tell graduates at high school or college you can't shake hands, to cancel public events, to shut off food and water to Mexico City, now causing rioting. They love it. They're also admitting themselves, as Janet Napolitano said last Sunday, now 6-7 days ago, that, oh, this flu will probably fade out, but another big pandemic will come, will happen. It's a foregone conclusion. So let's not forget about that. And they're saying that this flu will probably mutate right around the fall when flu season begins, so we better all go roll up our sleeves and get the shot they're going to have right on time. They're talking about the federal government paying for 600 million doses for the 300 million Americans. Do you know how much profit that is when they're talking about the drug company that's chosen to make the vaccine get as much as $20 per shot? What's 20 times 600 million? You can pull that up. In fact, Google for folks so they can see it. 600 million vaccines to be made. I want them to, that just came out today. We'll throw that up on screen for you. Not to mention the Tamiflu, antiviral drugs, and the rest of it. Also, understand that this is a phasing in. You know, the establishment keeps crying wolf. Oh, we're going to have martial law. Oh, we're going to have a police state. You know, they're saying this on Fox News and CNN and Time Magazine and CBS. over and over again, they're saying martial law is coming. Martial law is going to be here. Martial law will keep you safe. And so when they really bring in martial law, we're all conditioned just to accept it. And they're incrementally phasing in the martial law with military checkpoints for drunk driving or car wrecks. Or in Canada, they're announcing to stop drunks in the cities. It's all being announced. And, oh, yeah, Brigade Homeland, we're going to put 20,000 combat troops on the streets of America to deal with American terrorists. Then we get their own documents. It says returning veterans, gun owners, people that don't like the Federal Reserve. That's the main threat, according to Homeland Security. All this police state they built was for the American people, not for men in shadowy caves 8,000 miles away. So they're phasing all of this in. Also, in Austin, Texas, and all over the country, they are setting up mass quarantine tent cities underneath parking garages and in other facilities. In fact, just roll that video in the background without audio if we can. I don't think we even have time to play the clip. We played it Friday on the show. I want people just to see the tent cities. You can just Google tent cities for flu outbreak. They're drilling how to federalize the locals. They're drilling and saying the NORTHCOM and the military will have this role during the coming flu. This is all a beta test drill. Now, last Friday and Saturday, when we went on air, we said, we believe this is a hoax. We believe this is a fraud. You know, so they're saying that they've had 60-something deaths in Mexico. That's what they were saying last Saturday, 68 deaths. So what, if that's even true? Too bad for those people, but, you know, that's nothing compared to the 30-plus thousand, even if that's a hype number. Let's just go with the official CDC number. 36,000 people die a year of flu in the U.S. That many or more because of worse sanitation and less health care and more poor people in Mexico. You know, flu kills a lot of people. So do car wrecks. So does prescription drugs. So do bolts of lightning. So does drowning. So does homicide. None of us are going to make it out of this alive. Why are they saying, you know, UN headlines, the greatest threat to humanity could be greater than swine flu of 1918, could kill hundreds of millions. You know, all these headlines I'm going to go through from the week when they had 60-something deaths. And then later this week, they had to admit, oh, it's really 12 deaths or 7 deaths or 10 deaths, but it's not more than 12. Oh, we actually tested. Those people just died of the regular flu or they died of pneumonia. You know, in Mexico City, a 30-something million people. And the one 23-month-old toddler, God bless his soul, from Mexico City that died in Houston, Texas, came up here. Put him on a ventilator. He had been prematurely born, had lung diseases, all this stuff. So we know this is a fraud. This is an exercise in mind control. But there is a real threat there. There's a real danger there because I told you back on Wednesday night when I came on Burmese's show, 9 to midnight, the Info Warrior, that we had received from a local Austin school administrator who came here to the office and gave it to us, an internal memo. We gave you the name of the doctor and read it all on air, and we posted the document up at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. We're going to go over that in a moment, where they said, we're really at level 5, and we're going to level 6 tomorrow. And then at that time, when we said that Wednesday, we were at level 4. The next day, it did go to level 5, proving what we said. We're the folks that broke the MIAC report, the folks that broke the Homeland Security document. We're the folks that broke the clergy response teams. And people are questioning us, going, show us the whole document. We had to.